In the last section, we looked at profit maximization using a graph. Here we're going to take a look at how to maximize profits, at least for a firm in pure competition, using data from a table. So here's our table. We have in the first column quantity, or the total production, which ranges from 0 to 6, so we can produce 0 products, or 1, or 2, or 6. And then the next column is TFC, which is total fixed cost, and then next to that is total variable cost, TVC. And we have total cost, which of course is the sum of TFC and TVC. Next to TC is marginal cost, MC. And then we've got average variable cost and average total cost. So how do we figure out what quantity to produce in order to maximize profits? Well, this table only has the quantity produced and the cost data. So in order to talk about profits, we have to take revenue data and compare it to cost data. So we also have to know the price of the product. So let's add that to this table. First, we'll take a look at a price of $17. So we're going to put 17 here, all the way down. And we know that the price stays constant for a firm in pure competition, at least in the short run. And so that's also our marginal revenue, because for a firm in pure competition, the price is the same as the marginal revenue, as you know. So how do we maximize profits? Well, the golden rule of profit maximization is we got to see where the MC, the marginal cost, is the same as the marginal revenue. So here's your marginal cost column. And we've got to compare these numbers to the marginal revenue columns. There's a couple of footnotes with that golden rule of profit maximization. We should never look at any quantities where the marginal cost is falling. So we can ignore 1 and 2 because the marginal cost is falling there. And the first one we should start to look at is the quantity of 3. So at a quantity of 3, the marginal cost is 10, and the price, or the marginal revenue, is 17. Well, they're not really close. Let's see if we can get one that's closer. At a quantity of 4, the marginal cost is 13, and the price is 17. And they're closer, but not as close as the next one. At a quantity of 5, the marginal cost is 16, and the price is 17. So that's definitely one that we should keep in mind. That's where the marginal cost, they're not exactly equal in a table. A lot of times you're not going to find them totally equal, of course. In a graph, you will be able to get to the intersection, and the marginal cost and the marginal revenue are equal, but not in a table. By the way, if you look at a higher value for marginal cost, 20 and 17, relatively close, but you also have to keep in mind that marginal cost can never exceed the marginal revenue or the price. So quantity of 6 is definitely out because the marginal cost is greater than the price there. So the quantity of 5 is the one that we will pick here. And our golden rule of profit maximization tells us that at Q is 5, we are maximizing profits. Another footnote that we got to keep in mind is that we also have to make sure that the price is greater than the average variable cost at that quantity. And it actually is. Price is 17, and the average variable cost is 14.20, so the price is greater, so we're fine. We can maximize our profits using MC is MR, or MC comes close to MR, and so the quantity of 5 is where we maximize our profits. So let's write that down here. So that's our profit maximizing quantity when the price is 17. The other thing we can do with this profit maximizing quantity is figure out how much profit the firm is making at that quantity. Well, again, the price is 17, so the average revenue, which is equal to the price, is 17. We also see that at quantity 5, the average total cost is 16.20, so ATC is 16.20. So we have a profit of 80 cents, average profit, let's say AP, is 80 cents, which dollar signs in front of all that, but so 80 cents, and that means that the total profit is equal to 5. So TP, total profit, equals 5 times 80 cents. And so that's $4 for this firm. Now let's take a look at a second case where the price has dropped from 17 to 15. So now we have a price of 15 or a marginal revenue of 15. Our golden rule of profit maximization again says that we got to find the marginal cost that comes closest, or perhaps is equal ideally, but comes closest in the table to 15. Well, we have to ignore the first couple of quantities because the marginal cost is falling there. So the first one we can look at is the marginal cost of 10. 10 and 15 are not really that close. 13 and 15 are closer. So perhaps a quantity of 4 would be the best one. Let's just check to make sure that there isn't another one that comes closest. If we look at 16, then we see that 16 and 15 are close, but 16 is greater than 15, and we can never have the marginal cost being greater than 15. We would not be maximizing our profit. So this one is out. So the quantity of 5 is out, and that leaves us marginal cost of 13 and the marginal revenue of 15 as the closest one to the profit maximizing quantity. And that profit maximizing quantity here is 4. So Q equals 4 if the price is 15. We just have to check one more thing. We have to make sure that the price, which is 15, is greater than the average variable cost. And circle that 1375. Indeed, 15 is greater than 1375. So we're good there. We will actually produce this quantity of 4. And now let's figure out the profit, or perhaps the loss. So the average revenue is 15. It's the price. Average total cost is, that's average total cost, that's 16.25. So it is greater than the price, which means that we have an average profit of minus 1.25. So we have a loss of $1.25, which means that our total profit is 4, that's what we're producing, times minus 1.25, $1.25. And that means we have a loss of minus $5. Our third case is where the price is 12. So the price has really dropped now. It's only $12. And if we were to do the MC equal to, or comes closest to MR as possible, we would actually come up with a quantity of 3. So a marginal cost is 10 and the quantity would be 3. However, if we looked at another thing that we have to make sure of, and that is comparing the average variable cost to the price, we notice that the price now is less than the average variable cost at that quantity. In fact, the price is less than any average variable cost in at any of the quantities. And this tells us that because average variable cost is greater than the price, or the price is less than the average variable cost, we have to shut down, because if we do produce 3, then our loss would be greater than our fixed cost. If we shut down, we just have a loss of our fixed cost, and that would be better to have a less of a loss. So at a price of 12, because the price is less than the average variable cost, we produce at a quantity of 0. Now we know what our fixed cost is, and our fixed cost in our total fixed cost column is $10. So we know that our loss here equals $10 if we shut down. Of course, in the long run, we hope that the price increases, or we can reduce costs so we can start producing again.